Anti-aircraft gunfire pierces the night sky over Tripoli. The sounds of explosions rocked the Libyan capital in response to a multinational assault. The U.S. and European countries have fired cruise missiles and airstrikes in the widest military effort since the Iraq War. The U.S. military said Tomahawk cruise missiles were fired at more than 20 coastal targets to clear the way for air patrols to ground Libya's air force. Longtime leader Muammar Gadhafi called state television Sunday. He said he would not let up on rebel-held Benghazi in the east. He said the government had opened up weapons depots to all Libyans, who were now armed with automatic weapons, mortars, and bombs. State television said Gaddafi's supporters were converging on airports as human shields. The U.S. and Europeans focused their attention on the no-fly zone, but the U.N. resolution authorizing the action demanded a ceasefire and authorizes all necessary means to protect civilians. As the Libyan state television showed images of the wounded in a hospital, the International Red Cross said it was concerned about the risk to civilians. Libyan officials said nearly 50 people died since the assault began Saturday. President Barack Obama said Saturday that the military action was not his first choice and reiterated that he would not send American ground troops.
We cannot stand idly by when a tyrant tells his people that there will be no mercy.
Defense officials cautioned it was too early to fully gauge the impact of the onslaught, but a senior defense official said the Americans felt that Libya's air defenses had been heavily damaged. Matt Friedman, The Associated Press.